Hi there, welcome back. I've got a Winkhaus Entra. It's a 6-pin dimple. I've got security pins inside, spools, and what looks like a T-pin, sort of, I guess. All the security pins are tapered too, which makes it a little bit more fun. The key works. Put that off to the side, and here we go. All right, one is loose, two is loose, no binding. Rotation, click, 3 is loose, 4 is binding, a little click out of 4 and a little core movement, 5 is loose, 6 is loose, 1 is loose, 2 is binding, a little tiny click out of it, a little core rotation, 3 is loose, 4, a tiny bit of rotation on that, there's a little tiny click, 5 is loose, no, the tiniest of clicks on 5, 6 is loose, 1 is loose, 2 is binding, little click out of 2, 3 is loose, 4 is loose, 5 is loose, sorry, this is 5, 6, two. Here's the tapereds doing their thing. 3 is loose. A little bit of movement on 4. 5 is binding again. A little click on 5. 6 is loose. 1 is loose. 2 is loose. 3 is loose, 4 is loose, sorry that was 5, I think I lost count there, 6 is loose, 1 is loose, little click on 2 and some more core rotation, 3 is loose, 4 was binding a little bit, a little more rotation. 5 feels loose. 6 is loose. 1 is loose. 2 is binding again. Oh, click on 2 and some good counter, sorry, some good core rotation. 3. 3 is loose. 3 feels set, actually. 4 is binding. 4 is that set? Yeah, it's a little springy. I think 4 is set. 5 is binding. There, little click on 5, more rotation. 6. Loose. 1 is loose. 2 feels springy. 3 loose. Four. Four feels good. Five feels loose. Six is springy. One feels loose. Back to two. A little bit of core rotation on two. Good. Four feels good. Five feels a little. There we go, and it's open on five. Oh, lock that back up. Okay, let's see if we can gut this. Keep it in frame. All right. Where is my tool? There it is. All right, we've got the key, so let's lock that back up. Get this guy off. Nothing tricky on the core on this one, except there are some key control pins along there. There's five of them. There's two pins, the two passive pins there and there, and then in between them, there's a fun little trap pin. I'll show you that once we get this out. Okay. Picked that. Which way are we going here? Which way are the key pins? That way. Got it. Key pins are up. Passive pins. Okay, I'm definitely gonna drop something here. Let's do. I can't decide. Let's do this. Follower. Okay. Oh yeah. I'm gonna go this way. Okay, there. I've made up my mind. There's a whole whack of pins in here. Let's see if I can keep them all. Can be expected. Let's keep that in frame. And camera. Sorry about the camera shake. I think I'm going to invest in something better soon. Let's put this guy over here. Alright. Now, where are all these pins? Let's get this guy out. And do what first? Do these ones first. Okay. And pick. Tweezers. There's that funny little trap pin. Come on, you. Get in here. that's what. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3. Fell out. Alright, well, we're all in now. Let's just knock them all out. 4, 6. Okay, key pins. 1, 2, 3. Come on now. 5 and 6. Everything fall out. Good. All right, then there's these two. Put them there. Put them there and there. There's the trap pin. Let's get it gutted and then I'll walk through what the pins are. It for the core. Let's see this. Okay, I'll come back to this. Let's put that there. There is the spool. First one was standard, second spool, there's like, I don't know, I call that a T-pin, I don't know if I'm using that term correctly. Another spool, another T, and a big old standard at the back. There. Let's get the springs out. There it is. There we go. Okay. Anything special about the core? There's the slot for. What's that slot for? Oh, these pins, I guess. Yeah, okay, so those pins, if the wrong key's inserted, the pins will stick out of the core and fall into, or rather, extend into that slot. Okay. Alright. Here we go. Alright, let's get in closer. So the key pins, there's these cool little, I think you'd call that an overset trap, little spooled key pin, if you get a little ambitious with your picking, another one on one, spooled key pin. The other key pins are pretty plain. Here we've got one of these, which I think is a T-pin. There's a little tapered, narrower section on each end. So these things require a couple bumps before they get set. You can see the taper on the spool. These ones require a bunch of bumps too. Springs, standard on 1, standard on 6. And I'm gonna pull back a bit. So right here, there's a little spot where this pin fits. You can see that? And a tapered midsection. Anyway, it sits in here, and it doesn't really do anything. Unless, I think it functions as a trap. The pin doesn't actually extend into the keyway, so it doesn't like interact with the key. But there is a little spot, there is a hole where you can, where'd it go? Come on. There it is. So if you get stuck, I think it's a trap for the drivers. Let's see, how well does a driver fit? What would that line up with? Looks like it lines up with pin stack 2, which in this case is a spool. So if you're not paying attention, that could get stuck in there. But it is recoverable from the inside. You can pick that out. Oh, that guy fell out. And then there's these two, which sit in these holes, and they interact with the key on those two slots. There's dimples there and there. Oh yeah, and then they would line up with that second slot right there. So that's it. The Winkhaus, not sure how you pronounce it, Entra, picked, gutted. It's ranked at a blue belt. Anyway, nothing else to say. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.